did he make contact with that left?
Not that I'm aware of.
Now Girard swung around to the near side. It got past Rantanen and Soderberg. Out comes Couture. Here's Nyquist. Lost the handle. Trying to get it back in the corner. Timo Meyers on it. Here's Meyers shooting. Loose in front. Couture scores. Logan Couture is on the board in round two.
Well, don't blame the goaltender for this one. Grubauer was able to make a save or two before Couture finds it. Couture is up right at the dot right now, 39. Watch him. Misses, finds it, and then puts it in on the back end. What an effort.
No question. You see, Cale Makar couldn't match up with Couture, but Gus Nyquist did a great job getting the floor play away from that puck, and that allowed Couture to win the race and put it to the back of the net. But a good job by Nyquist playing without the puck to get in front of the opposition goaltender and cause some problems.
He's got that look in his eye, doesn't he, Logan Couture? When the playoffs come around and the games get more important, he gets better.
And again, he said this morning, I got to get going.
He did.
And he has come through with the icebreaker here in game three. Seventh of the playoffs for Couture, who had four in the final three games of that Vegas series.
He got going in game seven, I'll tell you that, in the last 7 minutes.
So five goals in the last six for Couture. And San Jose has the lead in game three. Both of the kitty court blue liners assist on the goal. Girard with his first point of these playoffs. And Cale Makar on Nieto's fourth of the playoffs at 11:45. Here's Couture shooting, scores! Logan Couture answers back.
A turnover by Colorado. And Couture stayed in the offensive zone, hoping he might get it back. Here's the door off, can't handle it. Watch Couture, 39, left side of your screen. Stays there, he gets it, and then this shot off the crossbar and in to give San Jose the one-goal lead again.
What an act of deception right there by Logan Couture, a thing of beauty. Watch this little move right there. That gets Grubauer up and off the post, and Couture's able to beat him short side. Just a brilliant piece of offensive wizardry by Logan Couture.
Are they looking at a possible offside here? There's a little bit of a delay. The Colorado coaches were looking at something on the bench. No, they're going to drop the puck.
Good goal, 65 seconds after the equalizer for Colorado. Logan Couture with his second of the night. Stakes the Sharks to a new lead. 7 minutes left in the third period. 12:50 the time of the Couture go-ahead goal. From the draw, Sharks control, and now Barry. Rink-wide Rantanen and Grubauer itching out of the net. They don't have control yet. Now he'll go. Kept in by Barry. Extra attacker on route, and it will be JT Comfort. He'll go to the front of the net to say, moving around the outside. Back to Barry again. No shot yet. No shot on the power play. One coming, but McKinnon had it knocked down, and they get it out. 70 seconds to go. Evander Keane's got it with an empty net, and he missed it. Swung off balance, and he was unable to put it away, but down to the final minute, and Couture getting set to return. Here comes McKinnon. Nathan McKinnon backhand stop by Martin Jones, and the Burns clearance all the way back inside the Colorado line. Couture stays out. Goodrow is with him. At center, Goodrow the turnover. Can't get it through to Couture. Colorado trying to retrieve it. That was gloved and knocked down by Carlson. Scores! And it's Logan Couture with the hat trick goal to clinch it here in Denver.
The defending of San Jose, both on the power play and then through the neutral zone. They knock it down, and Logan Couture finds it, spins, and all in one motion, the clincher.
What a sensational night for a guy who put all kinds of pressure on himself this morning to deliver, and he did just that.
He stood there in front of everyone, and he said, we got to be better. He didn't think his team was good in the first two games. His coach says, you know what? He's just pointing at himself when he says things like that, and boy, did he ever deliver in game three.
Got them going, got them back in the lead, and has put what looks like the finishing touches on this one. Grubauer back to the bench for the extra attacker again, now in a 4-2 game. Kerfoot's got it. Point from Makar. Takes the shot wide. Ricochets to LeBanc and out. As the clock winds to a conclusion here. And the San Jose Sharks have won their third in four road games in the Stanley Cup playoffs and have reclaimed home ice advantage with a big road win at Pepsi Center. Well, the Avalanche made it interesting as they pulled back into a tie, but Couture unties it and finishes it. Time for our Sprint Three Stars of the game.
Well, certainly Logan Couture with the hat trick was just tremendous in leading his team. And there were others that really stood out. Philip Grubauer kept his team in it early until they were able to get their legs. And Timo Meier, every time he's on the ice, something seems to happen. He finishes with a three-point game.
And the top star is with Pierre McGuire.
Thanks very much, Chris. You told me after game one, even though you won the game, your team wasn't particularly good. How good were you tonight?
I still think we got more. I think we sat back too much. They're a very, very fast, skilled team. We gave them too much through our neutral zone. Turned too many pucks over, but we found a way. Joner made some big-time saves.
With Joe Pavelski being on the lineup, how much more pressure are you feeling, Logan?
I mean, I always feel pressure. It's the playoffs, and I'm the leader on this team. I've been around for a while. I want to score. I want to produce. I want to help this team win. And we haven't gotten to where we want to go in my 10 years here. And we're trying to get there. So a lot of guys in our team are leaders, and we got a great group.
What'd you establish here in game number three that's going to help you in game four?
I mean, we didn't finish too strong. We didn't have a great third period, so we need to get back to forechecking. That's when we're at our best. Their D can't handle us when we're forechecking hard and using our size, playing to their end. And I don't think we did it enough tonight, but when we did it, we were successful.
Best way to describe Martin Jones's performance?
Yeah, great, calm. You know, this is fun when he's playing like this. He's such a good goaltender, and it was a tough year for him, I'm sure. And start of the playoffs didn't go the way we wanted it to as a team, and we left him hanging out to dry a bunch of times, and he's the one that took it. So he's playing great right now.
I thought your second goal was a spectacular display of offensive wizardry. Can you take us through it, what you were thinking?
Yeah, I mean, at first I thought it was offside, but the play kept going on. I looked up, I saw it. I thought I had Timo with me. He wasn't with me. Their D-men kind of backed off a little bit, then he came towards me. I was able to look off Grubauer and post an in.
Congratulations on winning game three. We'll see you Thursday night for game four. Logan, way to go.
Thanks, Pierre.
CC.